गुरु समर्था विघ्न हरता, गुरु समर्था भक्त लाज तुझला, चिंताकार व्यर्थ मजला। सर्व भाव तुला अर्पिला, चिंताकार व्यर्थ मजला। सूत्रधारी तू सूत्र बाहुलिनी, सूत्रधारी तू सूत्र बाहुलिनी, अहम भाव नुरला कर्तृत्वाभिमान सरला, कर्तृत्वाभिमान सरला, चिंताकार व्यर्थ मजला।
जयश्री माताजी, dear brothers and sisters, let's collectively start this new day of meditation by a collective conscious namaskar, with the consciousness that the whole world is doing namaskar to the Devi as guru, as primordial guru. Namaskar, Kundalini.
विघ्नहर्ता गुरु
In Holland, which is the holy land of Europe, and the holy land of Europe has got lots of water in it flowing. It's at a lower level than the Mother Earth, and the sea flows through it. So it's a good combination of the sea and the earth here. So sea cleanses and the Mother Earth blesses the people of Holland. But if they have lost their moorings and they are flying in the wrong direction, then the same holy land can become a hell land. So we have to be very careful to see that we create more and more Sahaja Yogis in this place. In my reading of the character of the Western people, I find they are extremely aggressive by nature and very egoistical on the whole. One should not feel that I'm saying about you, but I'm saying you are Sahaja Yogis, you belong to the kingdom of God, but I'm telling about in general. Now, while I'm talking, keep your eyes open. I don't know why people close the eyes, I can't understand. Now, when we are in the Holy Land, we find that the Mother Earth has allowed the sea to flow in and is a very good place for me to say something to you. Here the sea has taken refuge in the Mother. The Guru has bound itself with the motherly qualities. A person feels more safe on the ground than on the sea or in the air. So today is the best opportunity for me to say that after the Guru Puja, we have to understand that to be holy means you must allow the Guru Tattva to circulate in the Mother principle. Or the Guru Tattva is to be controlled and guided and beautified by the Mother Prism. It's only the Mother Earth that is beautiful because it can create so many varieties, so many dramas, so many plays. Any other element, if you see, has nothing in it. So it is she who can create. So we should take to the motherly quality more and try to bind our Guru principle through that motherly, beautiful, creative power so that we make our presence very agreeable, very congenial, very beautiful. Full of interest and varieties, every time new flowers, every time new fruits, every time a new design. As Kundalini is made of Mother Earth, we are quite capable of doing that. There are gurus and gurus and gurus, but no one so far is such a master as you are of the Kundalini. If they were, they would have given realization to thousands. Why? Because your mother has penetrated into your guru principle and has risen your Kundalini, has given you powers to raise Kundalini, breaking your seventh chakra so clearly. That never happened with anyone. Even incarnations could not do that to the masses, as you are doing. The Kundalini is flowing from your hand. The Ganesha is active in you. But it should never give you the ego or the sternness or the heaviness of the sea. But it should give you the beauty of the Mother Earth. Mother Earth is always bigger than the sea, because she has to contain the sea. Sea can never be bigger than the Mother Earth. Sometimes it looks sea bigger, but sea is contained in the Mother Earth. It cannot go beyond. So Mother Earth is always greater, bigger, wider than the sea. So one has to understand that when Kundalini has risen, you have become all the seven chakras and not only the Guru Chakra. When you have become the Guru Chakra, it is also bounded on all sides by the Mother Earth. Under these circumstances, when we are so capable, we are giving realization to so many people, when we are achieving so many things, if we could just become humble, congenial, beautiful, we can master the whole world. But I find in the styles of Sahajyogi, especially in the West and Westernized Indians, there is so much of ego still expressed in their talks, in their behavior. They are not capable of it, to see, I think, sometimes, but better see it. First you may have to act as we do. Maybe. But you must learn that way. If you do not understand that all your leadership, all your Guru Tattva depends entirely on the loving capacity of your mother, her patience. I get angry, but perhaps once in a 10 years or 12 years, something like that. Seldom. That's better. Then the anger has some meaning. But all the time if you are in a temper or you try to show off or if you have so much of ego that you go on asserting on wrong things, then you cannot be effective. Another thing I've seen, that ego has no discretion. Ego has no discretion of any kind. If you are egoistical, first thing you lose is discretion. Then what's the use of having this nonsense of an ego which doesn't give you discretion? And people who have greater ego always then assert, and you have to agree to that. You are more impressed by the people who have greater ego than yours. And you like the people who are without any ego, so you can oppress on them. But the discretion part is very poor, that you can see. The other day one guru had come, the one gentleman had come, and he has given some mantra by his guru. Now he can't hear anything against his guru. Why? Because his ego has chosen that guru. Because the ego has chosen, how can the ego be wrong? An ego is always wrong. Invariably it is wrong. Everything is upside down with the ego orientation. Gradually you will learn that in the West, people lack common sense. Completely they lack common sense in everything. I mean, if they had common sense, there would have been much less problems. But common sense is lacking, and also I find the same thing in Sahaja Yogis. They lack common sense. You have to become so wise that common sense should be your nature. But common sense we lack. Like today, I'll have some water. Today I was discussing about, say, the labor problem, which is a very general problem. Which is a very general problem. You have a labor problem. For example, you have an employment. Now the whole system that is built in here, and we too have adopted some of it, but not to that extent, of working hours is very absurd. For example, supposing you get up at 4 o'clock. I mean, that's very big supposition, of course, but supposing we get up at 4. And we take our bath. Morning time is very peaceful. We can meditate. We can do what we like. Then we finish all the other work we have to do. Get yourself ready. Have yourself ready. Have your breakfast or tea or whatever you want to have. Then by 8 o'clock you are ready for work. Supposing you go at 8 o'clock for your work. So, you can work from 8 up to 1 o'clock very easily. Very easily, no problem. Then 1 o'clock, you come back home, have your lunch and have a siesta. If you can have siesta for about 2 hours, till 4 o'clock, by 5 o'clock you again go to work. Then you can work from 5 to 11 without feeling tired at all. After 11 you might be. So you put in much more work, much less sleep, and you keep fresh and young. But it requires common sense. Now the how unemployment can be solved? Some people can work in the morning, some can work in the evening. Now those who are working in the morning, the ladies could be in the house, men could be outside. Then the men come out in the evening, they can do the household work. Ladies can do in their house, or when they are in the house, men can do creative work. Like making statues, handwork, handmade things. So everybody gets employment. They became more creative, much happier people, and so easy to solve the problem. But there is unemployment. Because of unemployment, there are so many problems. Very easy to solve the problem of unemployment. You don't give any social security or anything. You give them their pay and let them work for shorter time. If you make them create things and sell them, they have more money. Or they can have nice things around them. Otherwise you can have horrid things like that. So you can have lots of things which are handmade. Plus machine-made things, whatever you want to have, there should be a balance. With common sense we should know how far to go. How far to have balance? Like machine goes on like mad, we cannot control machines. Because we think we get money, we do not. After some time, machines have to stop. So you have to go up to this. I'm trying to put the Guru Tattva into the Mother Tattva. As practical. So, common sense should be applied. And that can only come when there is no ego. With ego there cannot be common sense. Because I like it, I do it. But this I is an ego who is blind, who is indiscreet, who is stupid. So ultimately we do stupid things. There should be common sense which one can learn by getting rid of this. Now, people say, Mother, how to get rid of ego? It's very simple, you have to move left to the right 108 times in Sahaja Yoga. You have to forgive people in Sahaja Yoga. And you can watch yourself. First of all, see, do you watch others or you watch yourself, first of all? Like there was a lady traveling with me, very old lady. And she said, this man is handsome, this man is not handsome, this woman is good looking, she is pretty, that. I was looking at her, I said, this mad woman, she will go really crazy by the time we get down. She goes on looking into every person, judging everyone, who is handsome, who is not. And everybody whom she called handsome, I found him ugly. So I gave up. I said, you better decide. I never try these things. Then, that man is not good, he is very hot-tempered, he is this thing, he is that, he talks like that, he walks like that, he shouldn't look like that. Worried about other people. You tell them anything, they'll go on shaking their neck like that. Oh, how could you do it? But you do it yourself. If they have to say yes, they'll do it 10 times. Yes, 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 yes. If they have to say no, they'll go on saying no, 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 no. There's no common sense. Why to move your neck so many times? See, if somebody's saying that, you need not react all the time. So this is another thing, internal reaction. First is external. Seeing everyone, judging everyone, oh, I don't like this station, this is too much dusty, this bathroom is not good, that room is not good, that thing is not good, like that. As if you are the Queen of England. Even that could be even more than that, because she's not even allowed to choose her dress. Parliament has to decide. Poor thing cannot have any ego at all, poor thing. She has to choose what dress she has to wear for a particular occasion. If the parliament says yes, she wears. She says no, no. Big problem for them. But for us who are free people, we must have common sense to understand what to do, where to do, what to talk, how to talk. But when there is ego, you cannot have common sense. And this is the reason I think the Western people have become so stupid in so many things. Whatever I see it upside down. Indians, we may be poor people in the villages. They are not so educated. You are all very well educated people. Everything is there. But all has come out of ego. So the common sense is lacking. So those who deal with the Mother Earth, like farmers, have tremendous common sense. Now in Holland, I used to think people will have lot of common sense because they are farmers, you see. When I had come in 65, they were better off, much better people, not so nonsensical. They were well-dressed, nice, sensible, solid people. Of course, I met quite elderly people also, I should say. But I was surprised that in the market you could not get a transistor made in Holland, could not get anything made in Holland. So I said, how is it? You don't make anything machine? He said, why should we? For our 25 bulbs of tulips in those days, we get one transistor from Japan. So why should we make a transistor? Common sense. We sent from here 25 bulbs, and they had fields and fields of all kinds of tulips all over, I mean, when I came here. So they said, for 25 bulbs we get one transistor, so why should we? We export our bulbs to them and get their transistors. Why should we make transistors? Then they said, we export our cheese to a particular country, or eggs to Italy, or chicken to this country, and we get all that we need. I was amazed. You see, they're so proud of their agriculture and so much doing like that way, which was a very sensible thing. And because they were dealing with the land, I thought I'll find Holland people to be the best. But then I got reports that people are absolutely gone off their heads. They have like become like bullocks now. Working with the land, they have become like bullocks who plow the land. I was surprised. How have they become like bulls? They were very sensible people, very sensible. Farmers, sensibly dealing with things and working out things in such beautiful manner. Very innocent and simple people. And naive, up to a point of sweetness, very sweet. When we came here, they wanted to please us, so they wanted to put a flag for us, of our country. And they put Pakistan's flag in front of us. So I was very happy to see that. And they were talking vegetarianism, but when we came, my daughter had suddenly become vegetarian because she had developed a funny nausea in the ship, you see. So she was not eating any meat or anything. So she said, I am vegetarian. So they said, all right, then will you have chicken? They were that simple, you know, very simple people. And now they're talking about vegetarianism. I'm surprised in 65 and 85 only, in these 20 years, how much they have changed. Very nice. And they were not busy doing all these exercises and reducing weight or increasing weight and jogging on the road. Just now, yesterday I was walking, everybody was jogging like mad. Very sensible. But they have lost their common sense. Because perhaps they do not come in contact with Mother Earth, they are using machines too much. Maybe that is one of the reasons. And must be the air from other outside countries coming, and they think they are rustic, so they must accept that is all that is modern, sophisticated, perhaps, maybe. There's a story about a farmer who was traveling by train. And there were some naughty boys who came from the city, so they wanted to pull the legs of the farmer. So one of the boys asked him that if the eggs are selling here in this station for 20p and in the next station the chicken is selling for £1, what is my age? Just to tease him. So immediately the fellow says, you must be 22. He said, how do you know exactly I'm 22? He said, because my brother, who is full mad, is 44. You see, they are so practical, so brass, you see, as you call in American level, brass tacks, you see, they know what is it. He looked at him and he said, 22? He said, how? Why? My brother, who is 44, is full mad. And these boys didn't know where to look, you see, because they wanted to tease him. And the farmers have great sense. Like we had one minister who had developed a bad neck, you see, why Vishuddhi, prime minister, he was chief minister, he used to go on like this, his head used to go like this. So some farmers came to see him. They saw him and they looked at him. They said, oh, he's saying no already, what's the use of telling him anything? We have lots of stories of farmers in India, which shows how much they understand life. I had a very nice gardener. He was from a village. So there was one fellow, old fellow, another gardener. He says, "No use talking to this old fellow." I said, "Why?" He said, "If he is a Hindu, then an old man is a gone case." I said, "Why?" "Because in young age they live like ascetics and in old age they become like bhoots. But if he's a Muslim, they don't live like ascetics in young age, they enjoy life and in old age they are satisfied souls. So you better talk to a Muslim old man than to an Hindu old man." I mean, the reading is so correct about things, you know. Everything that he said was so practical and so sensible. I was really surprised how he could say these things with such sweetness and with such goodness. And how he understood so many things so well. And he was a very young fellow, about, I would say, 30, 32 years of age. So he came to Bombay to see us. He didn't know our full address, he only knew Marine Drive. So he told the fellow, his taxi fellow, "You drive me at Marine Drive." He said, "Marine Drive is a big place," you said, "drive me anywhere in Marine Drive." He drove. So he went and asked, "Is there a very tall gentleman staying in Marine Drive somewhere?" And see, my husband is one of the tallest in Indians, you see. So he went to the servants, asked, "Have you seen any tall sahab anywhere?" He said, "There's one tallest staying there, you see." So that's how he came to our house. And he showed them his shoes. "This shoe is given to me by my sahab. He's also very tall, you see." So he said, "This shoe he has given me. And he wears the same style of shoes." So servants notice all these things. They were practical people. So another gardener who met him, he said, "Yes, there's a tall fellow and he wears the same type of shoes." So he came to our house. How they are sharp and how their eyes are so penetrating, how they know everything about everything. It is remarkable, very remarkable. And that is what we have to be. We have to be gurus.
Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha. Let's start the meditation by putting both hands on the floor. Shri Ganesh Mantra. Collectively from the heart. Om Tvameva Sakshat Shri Ganesha Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha. Again, with the intention of awakening Shri Ganesha in Mother Earth. Om Tvameva Sakshat Shri Ganesha Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha. Om Tvameva Sakshat Shri Ganesha Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha. Om Tvameva Sakshat Shri Ganesha Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha. Shri Adi Bhumi Devi Mata. Om Tvameva Sakshat Shri Adi Bhumi Devi Mata Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha Om Tvameva Sakshat Shri Adi Bhumi Devi Mata Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha Om Tvameva Sakshat Shri Adi Bhumi Devi Mata Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha Om Tvameva Sakshat Shri Adi Bhumi Devi Mata Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha Let our awareness go beyond Sahasrara and be in the collective Sahasrara of the Virat, while we at the same time collectively surrender to Mother Earth, ego, superego, mind, and all our channels, all our chakras. And also we surrender element Earth in us to Mother Earth, so that we can be balanced from within and have the guru gravity. As Mother Earth is the best guru and the guru of our mother, Sri Adi Shakti. let's put the left hand on the lap. Shri Mahakali Bhairava. Om Tvameva Sakshat Shri Mahakali Bhairava Sakshat Shri Adishakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha. One more time, let the mantra resonate at the Virat level to clear the left side of the Virat collectively. Om Tvameva Sakshat Shri Mahakali Bhairava Sakshat Shri Adishakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha. Complete surrender of Sundari. Now, let's put ego 7 times on the floor, from ego to the floor. Let's put the right side down. So left side still remains on the lap. And with the right hand 7 times, we are pushing ego down 7 times. With full awareness, full consciousness of what we are doing. And we put the right hand on the lap, left hand over the shoulder. Shri Mahasarasvati Hanumana. Om Tvameva Sakshat Shri Mahasarasvati Hanumana Sakshat Shri Adishakti Mataji
Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha.
Complete collective surrender of ego, of mind, of thoughts, of the subtlest reactions and actions that are coming from the right side. For 1 more minute, let's surrender the ego of the whole humanity. We keep the right hand on the lap, left hand over the shoulder. 1 more minute, with the pure desire to surrender the whole ego of all humanity, of all our leaders, of the whole world, so that ego is totally absorbed and only remains heart. Both hand on the lap, Let's say one more time Sri Ganesh mantra to dive deep into the meditation with auspiciousness. Om Tvameva Sakshat Shri Ganesha Sakshat Shri Adishakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha. One more time with complete focus on the Lord Ganesh in his complete form. Om Tvameva Sakshat Shri Ganesha Sakshat Shri Adishakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha.
के 12 नाम ओम श्री सुमुखाय नमो नमः ओम श्री एकदंताय नमो नमः ओम श्री कपिलाय नमो नमः ओम श्री गजकर्णाय नमो नमः ओम श्री लंबोदराय नमो नमः ओम श्री विकटाय नमो नमः ओम श्री विघ्ननाशकाय नमो नमः ओम श्री गणाधिपाय नमो नमः ओम श्री धूम्रकेतवे नमो नमः ओम श्री गणाध्यक्षाय नमो नमः ओम श्री भालचंद्राय नमो नमः ओम श्री गजाननाय नमो नमः साक्षात श्री आदि शक्ति माताजी श्री निर्मला देव्यै नमो नमः
Now, Sri Adi Guru Dattatreya, we are collectively saying the mantra to the primordial guru, to our mother under her complete form as primordial guru, guru of all the gurus. Om Tvame Sakshat Shri Adi Guru Dattatreya Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha Om Tvameva Sakshat Shri Adi Guru Dattatreya Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha.
let's try and be truly collective in the Virat and totally surrender to the principles of the Guru, to the 10 Gurus, primordial Gurus in the void of the Virat. Let's truly experience the glory, the gravity and the power of the Guru by truly being collective, truly be in the Virat energy and truly being surrendered.
Mandava sarva medatti jatam manaschena la.
Now, we need to be really, truly collective and have a strong collective attention that acts in the second because it is collective and because it is focused with pure desire. With the mastery of the Guru, of the primordial Guru, to whom we have connected, let's collectively unite in the heart, in the left heart. Let's perceive the glory of Sri Shiva, of the spirit, the primordial spirit. And let's take Sri Shiva from our heart and go into Brahmarandra with the energy of the spirit, which is bigger than everything that exists. And when we are at Brahmarandra, we just project the spirit into the five elements. It's a huge, big boom in our Sahasrara, where we project consciously the glory, the beauty, the greatness of the spirit into the five elements. And all the five elements are completely enlightened at the minute, at the second. And are drenched with the pure energy and the pure vibration of Sri Shiva himself, who is now Sri Sadashiva in Brahmarandra. While we are doing that, Mother Kundalini is rising even more powerful as the Shakti. She is rising gloriously, powerfully within us as the Virat, and unites with Sadashiva in Sahasrara. Sri Adi Kundalini, Sri Sadashiva are totally united and vibrate the whole five elements of the whole creation and beyond. Let's feel the greatness of our Sahasrara, the immense and powerful surge of Mother Kundalini, the huge presence of the spirit and its radiating glory in our Sahasrara. And again, from the gravity of the Guru, we are just watching. Our father and our mother in Sahasrara and totally surrendering to them as well. Let's put planet Earth in our attention, in Saraswara, in the primordial Saraswara, in the glory of Sri Sadashiva and Sri Adishakti. So that they can enlighten the whole planet Earth. The whole humanity should feel at this very second the complete love of the Devi, the complete vibration of the divine. Every single human being must feel at this very second the joy, the bliss, the peace, and feel that something from their divine realm is happening within them. May our collective attention also propel all the seekers of truth to seek and to find Sahaj Yoga everywhere in the world. May they be guided by the Lord Ganesh, by Sri Hanuman, and by all the deities to have their realizations, to become a new generation of yogis that can push further the work of the Devi. Let's further empower our attention by going even wider and higher above Saraswara, using the mastery of the Guru and his gravity and her gravity. Let go higher and wider, vertically and horizontally, above the collective primordial Saraswara. We can perceive all the superior chakras. We can perceive the whole creation and beyond, the millions and millions of universes. We can perceive the complete divine realm, all the deities, all the enlightened souls, all the great beings, through the vibration of the Devi. We can perceive it all. And also, just open our heart completely to the joy, to the bliss, to the complete presence of God, the Mother, and God, the Father. Before finishing the meditation, let's collectively surrender from our heart to the complete protection of the Guru, the complete presence of the Guru in our being, but also in our lives, in the lives of all the yogis of the world. And may the Guru, through the divine vibrations, bring Dharma and gravity on each human being so that the world become a better place to live, so that human beings stop all the destruction and everything that is adharma. Stop destroying themselves, destroying others, destroying nature, and being unaware of their greatness, and that love is the only solution moving forward. Let's take 30 seconds to absorb the maximum vibration before finishing the meditation. Let's open our awareness to the maximum and just imbibe the highest level of light, vibration, purity, divine energy. Collective Namaskar, Kundalini.
Sakshat Shri Adishakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devyai Namo Namaha. Gurur Brahma Guru Vishnu
Gurur Deva Maheshwara
Gurur Sakshat Parabrahma
Shri Mataji Nirmal Ma Shri Mataji Nirmal Ma Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha
Gurur Brahma Guru
Adi Guru Dattatreya Namo Namaha.